الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. It is an honor, wallahi, always to meet here and with the presence of Sheikh Hamdi and everyone. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and meeting, you know, under the umbrella of the Masjid, the Islamic Center. That is an honor by itself to be together. And I want to thank you, Brother Saleh. MashaAllah, يعني, you are adding a lot of values to the our community as well. Jazakallah khair. May Allah bless you and your parents. And everyone here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this night a special night for all of us. Ask Allah for forgiveness and we'll spend the next 20 to 25 minutes, inshallah, together. Just like to share some thoughts here and there. Definitely, next week, next Friday, next Thursday night is the first day of Ramadan. So, and I'm sure Sheikh Hamdi, mashallah, and all the speakers, you know, join us here. They talked about, but the only that this is so unexpected situation we are today, that with the COVID-19, this will be possible if that Muslims are always optimistic. Basically, Muslims should be optimistic in any situation, regardless of whatever going around them or the surrounding. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدْ. So indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he said in the Quran, we have certainly created man into hardship. So we are in a test all of our life. We are going through chapters after chapters that until we end our life here and start the true life, which is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment. And Allah says in the Quran, and he promised all of us with no exception, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. But the conclusion of this ayah, all the test and the trial, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala said, surely we shall test you, mankind, all people, with something of الخوف, fear, والجوع, hunger, loss in wealth, lives. We see in life, even watching the news, how many people being, you know, every day, lives, many, many people dying in the daily basis, reminding us, you know, our turn is on the way. We are on the line today, next month, 10 years, 20 years, but definitely there is a destination. And he concludes by وَنَقْصِ مِنَ من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين and lives and the fruits of your hard work as a farmer basically and the glad tidings for the patient. So inshallah, what I'm going to take from here, some keys for optimistics and how can we live our life based on the situation we live in and with Ramadan approaching us, the month of mercy, the month of love, the month of giving, of supporting, especially for our community we live in. There is hadith, which is, I'm sure all of you memorize this hadith, that Muhammad says, the Prophet says, you know, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ أَمْرُهُ كُلُّهُ لَوْ خَيْرٌ. Basically, how amazing is the case of a believer, all the believers. It is amazing how their life is. There is good for him in everything. So whatever happened around you, it's good. Regardless, you have an accident, it's good. Because you're going to translate that either to be thankful or practice patience. Thankful, or and both are good for the believer. So regardless what happened, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ أَمْرُهُ كُلُّهُ لَوْ خَيْرٌ إِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءٌ صَبَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ وَالْقَبْلَهَ طَبْعًا وَأَصَابَتْهُ سَرَّاءٌ شَكَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ وَلِيسَ ذَلِكَ الْمُؤْمِنِ الحديث طبعا في رواه مسلم. So this is the starting point. I wanna be with just remind you with this hadith and the key. So basically, there's a few points. I'd like to end my tonight with action items for all of us, inshallah, to keep with us and to keep, you know, for everyone to continue. We should pray and ask Allah to reward every Muslim working in any Islamic center or any school today and struggling and trying to keep the community together. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give those who are in the front line in behalf of all Muslims, working so hard by providing the services through the internet, through WebEx or Zoom or any means that to keep the faith and the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the heart of the people. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give every imam and every shaykh and every da'iyah today all the rewards and the patience, because we are going وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصًا مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of you, all of us will be among وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. So this is the beginning of this. So basically, what's happening in the world? Nothing outside the formula of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's control. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who created you and I, the one who created the universe, he is the one who created everything else, including coronavirus and everything else. So now people, they don't believe in Allah. Many of the people express, you know, publicly, we don't believe in God. But they believe in something we call it virus. And they are hiding behind their homes because they're afraid for their life. So imagine if you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deep in your heart and share this knowledge with everyone around us, with our neighbors, that, you know, we have this love in our hearts and satisfaction because we believe all of this in the hand of the one who created us and created the world. So based on that, what I want to share with you, and after this introduction, number one, Ramadan is coming, and all of us home with our families and children, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a key of success. Not only today, not tomorrow, but every day until we reach Ramadan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Ala bidhikri Allahi tatma'in," we're worried. Lay off 17 million, they lost their jobs. We're gonna get a job tomorrow. And all of this coming to your hand, to your heart. In the other hand, "Ala bidhikri Allahi tatma'in al-qulub." Number two, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to you and to me and to everyone, أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون فاذكروني أذكركم. Subhanallah, when he says, so remember me, I will remember you. Allah says, remember me, I will remember you. And be grateful to me and don't deny me. Don't reject me. ولا تكفرون. So this is one of the things I want to start with. Number one, remember Allah. Number two, give thanks. وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَأَنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَالنِّعَمِ وَلَأَنْ كَفَرْتُمْ. He never say anything about this life. إِنَّ عَذَابِ لَشَدِيدٌ. So you have to remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will surely increase you in favors, in a blessing, in giving to all of the internally and externally. But if you deny, indeed, my punishment is severe. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ibrahim, the one Sheikh Hamdi make us to memorize it a long time ago during Ramadan, about maybe 7 or 8 years ago. And I'm one of those who participating and memorize this surah in Ramadan, the project. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the Islamic Center and all the Islamic centers. Look for the positive. And wallahi, I will share with you something personal and something for all of you, even better than me, I'm sure. During the last Fridays, I realized, since we have kids in the house, every one of them is a potential speaker. Every one of them is a potential leader. So when you ask your child, say 7, 8, 9, 10, 15, to give a reminder and tell him, you know what, I want you to speak tonight about this. And when the time comes, all of you sit together, his father, his mother, his, you know, his brothers and sisters, older and younger than him, and he starts giving a khatira. This is an opportunity will never come again as simple as now. And not only that, even Jum'ah with the Shaykh, alhamdulillah, give a khutbah for all of us. Also, some of us have, you know, choose to have a khutbah in their home, and the khutbah will be given by one of the members of the family. So this opportunity training, it changes to be a positive. Look for positive. وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَعَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Subhanallah, when you think about this ayah, and there's many stories we read in the history of that it may be that you dislike something, you don't like something, and probably you do want to fast in Ramadan, you want to do a lot of things because you want to eat, for example. But you know what is it? coming after this, it's much better for you to fast, it's much better for you to give secretly, it's much better to you to be honest and to tell the truth all the time, because that even giving you hard time in the dunya, but in the day of judgment, خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُ وَتُحِبُّ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. This is number three. Look for the positive. Social distancing. Subhanallah. المعاصي خفت. ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر. This ayah talking about a lot of misconduct in this world. Today, subhanAllah, overnight, everything is closed. There's no major violations happening in the streets anymore. You don't see anything happening in the middle of the night and after because everybody home. So subhanAllah, the clean world, we've seen it clearly. There is ayah I will share with you in a few minutes, inshallah, about the cleanness by itself. So this is number four. وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرُوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. We believe what happened, inshallah, khair. Inshallah, khair. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it renewal our attention, intention, and make us all build our community stronger and better by proving the whole neighborhood that we are here to serve, we are here to lead, we are here to give the love and respect for everyone around us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among all this. The product of the masjid about giving the poor, I think who can do this except somebody, his heart connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Definitely, this is an amazing project and the projects we see all the time. Four, I'm not taking too long, inshallah. Number four, be patient. Be patient with your wife, with your husband, with the sisters, for your children. And subhanAllah, when you practice this in the right way, wallahi, I am one of those who enjoy being with my children lately. I love the way they pass. You always run from school to school, from meeting to meeting. And I realize the patient, you know, we have in the past is different than today. Today, mashallah, you feel you're practicing by force, but the outcome is good. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu ista'inu. This is the secret. Bil-sabr wa-salah. Inna Allah ma'a al-sabirin. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you think, Allah, I'm one of, you know, have a practice, you know, patient, and also, you know, I'm come to the salah all the time. Patient. You just, you know, have faith when you ask your family to pray together. But you want to take longer. Somebody wanna, you pray together. You have jama'ah. You have a new imam in the house every day because, you know, we're going to eat lunch after salah. We're going to eat dinner. You know, we have to eat. Then we have to pray isha. So you'll find out this patient is not easy. And again, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, many hadith, you know, and know that victory comes with patience. As the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said in the hadith, the victory come with patience. مَعَ الصَّبْرْ يَأْتِي النَّصْرْ. And number five, never give up. Never ever give up. Have faith. Remember your life in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And wallahi لو اجتمعت الإنس والجن على أن ينفعوك أو يضروك بشيء لن يتم. أن ينفعوك أو لن يضروك إلا بشيء قد كتب الله لك أو عليك كما ورد في الحديث. لذلك we have to, يعني لازم نؤمن إيمان عميق في قلوبنا إنه don't ever give up. If the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the darkness of the night in Mecca, when all the people, the non-believers surrounding his house, they want to kill them, with that he never gave up. He did the plan. He asked Ali radiallahu anhu, he walked through them, he went to the cave, he completed and the deen. Subhanallah, إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون. Victory will come guaranteed 100%. If not in this dunya, in the day after. And the nasr, مع الصبر مع الصادقين بإذن الله. So that's number five. Don't give up and always have faith. And after peace, number four. You know, to remember, billahi, how many of you, when we were making dua about the Muslims in China, the Muslims in Gaza, the Muslims all over the world, and we've seen the injustice served against them, we've seen them being killed and happen and prevent anyone to think of anything but coronavirus. Wallahi, amazing COVID-19. Wallahi, coronavirus, right? Wallahi, this is amazing. There's an enemy fighting the whole humanity in the same time, regardless of their position in this world, the strongest country in the world and the largest, welcome the population, country in the world, China, and Europe, with the advancement of technology, all of them today are prisoner of a jarthuma, of a virus. You need 200,000 times to make it, using like the microscopes, even to be seen. Imagine, subhanAllah, the power of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Allah إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول لكم فيكون. Now the question is, what about the Muslims? We all going this. سبحان الله. Nothing better than to have a shahada or ajr of shaheed if you stay home and respect that, you know, the, you know, staying home is based on the fact أن لا يخرج منها ولا يدخل إليه كما ورد في الحديث. سبحان الله. And number six and the last one of these points. Now, your tongue. إن الرجل لا يتكلم بالكلام. So watch your tongue, watch your thoughts, watch your mind. Be optimistic, because that will be translated through the wave of your body language to your family, to your friends, to your neighbors, to your relatives. So let's have patience. And look at the time, because Sheikh Hamdi told me, okay, alhamdulillah. So let me just share with you two things about optimistic. A story, I think we learn a lot from it, and I'm sure some of you, you know, heard. But I wanna translate how you can make the world whited in the eyes of the people around you, and how can you make even the sun dark if you choose the otherwise. You know the story of the man, two people in the hospital. One of them by the window, and the other person, you know, who is really really ill to the point he cannot get up. He always laying down, and he cannot see anything because he's extremely sick. So the one who's inside asked the one by the window, because he's like, you know, again, would you explain to me, well, can you explain what is going on in the window? And the guy by the window, he looked, you know, according to his mind, and said, oh, I see kids playing, I see flowers. He's just paint from the window what he sees to that person, like in detail. And that one, he have episode every day, like Barha. Every day he heard something new. Every day he heard, you know, there's a car passing by. There's somebody carrying a flower. Somebody with his, you know, and always giving him like the bright, you know, clear picture. One day in the morning, that patient, he expect his friend again to give him what's going on today. He never said anything. Finally, they found him dead in his bed. And he was so sad because nobody will tell him what is going on. So he asked the nurse, can you tell me what you see from the window? Or you can put me by that window. Then finally they moved him to that window, and he said, let me try my best to see whatever I can, even though he cannot move as you know, as should be. Then the nurse told him, what are you talking about? He said, in the window, do you see anything? There's a wall behind the window. There is nothing behind the window. And the guy who died, he was blind. Can you imagine how optimistic that person, when he just trying to bring happiness to someone? Let's be those who believe in Allah and have patience and have this nur bring that happiness to people. So when you look at it, there is two ayah I want to share with you, which is my conclusion. By saying my conclusion, I want to say to you, when you inshallah to read the Quran today and in Ramadan, as this Quran come to you, and think about what is happening in the world while you're reciting the Quran. And I want to share with you two ayah only, and inshallah I will stop. So read the Quran. You know, في ظلال القرآن, one of the books I have behind me, one of the ظلال القرآن, when Sayyid Qutb wrote that, you know, tafsir, he expressed what's going on in his time. So you find the word speaking to you when you understand what is going on with dhulm. So now look at this ayah, and Shaykh Hamdi, definitely he will correct all of us if there's anything, you know, to be added. الآيه في سورة طه, سيدنا موسى عليه السلام, when he was talking to Al-Samiri was an unbeliever basically, and قال له موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام, قال فاذهب فإن لك في الحياة أن تقول لا مساسة. سبحان الله, هاي الكلمة مساسة وردت على كل قراءات بنفس اللفظ مساسة. لا مساسة وإن لك موعدا لن تخلفه أو تخلفه, قراءتين, واحد براء بالفتح اللام واحد بكسرها, واثنين بعطيه معنى مختلف. القصة وما فيها إنه سيدنا موسى عليه السلام لما قال للسامري فاذهب فإن لك في الحياة أن تقول لا مساس. Go and anybody coming in your way, tell him no contact. You cannot touch me, I cannot touch you. Social distances, 6 feet or more. لا مساس. This is the Quran 1400 years ago. When you read it and look around you, Ya Allah, I'm walking in the morning. I go walk every day, by the way, in Manhattan Beach. There is a track. You walk as long as you want to, and they have big sign. Violation of you are not keeping 6 feet, $1,000. La misas. لا مساس، لا مساس، وإن لك موعد لن تخلفه أنت، وانظر إلى إلهك، إلى آخر الآيات. And Musa عليه السلام told a Samari, when you walk, you cannot touch anybody, and not only that, and nobody can touch you. You cannot contact anyone, and no one can contact you. When you read it, and I said, Subhanallah, and the reason why, because he have that disease, الجدر يعني مع المرض. If he touch somebody, he will transfer the disease. Quran taking care of people, of believers or non-believers 1400 years ago. This is one ayah. I want to just let the second ayah, when you read the ayah, which is we always all memorize in chapter 2, Al-Baqarah, ayah 222. So it's easy to remember it. 2 and 222, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. In fact, the thing which strike my mind when I read this ayah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ. The most important thing in your life to have good status with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then whatever you do, make sure you are okay with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. Regardless of the mistake, regardless how big it is. And I'm asking you, I'm inviting all of us today, myself first, and everyone, let's take advantage of today, and inshallah, and clear our hearts by saying, inshallah, may Allah accept us, all of us, among the tawabin. Tawabin, those who acknowledge their mistakes, people, and at the same time, clear their inner, and what about outside? وَيُحِبِّ الْمُتَطَهِرِينَ. Listen to the news. Washing your hands. When you walk, you have to wash your feet. And all of what we do today in the world, that's exactly what we learn when we make wudu and we take shower as Muslims. I'm talking about, you know, even Friday, the Prophet ﷺ taught us, you know, come to the masjid, you take shower. Why is that? Because إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِرِينَ. This is the way we want to read the Quran. We don't want to wait always for someone to tell us what is the meaning of this and that. We have to listen. We have to take the right direction. We have to give the respect to the ulama. We have to follow the right direction. I'm not asking anyone to read the Quran like this is my Quran. No. I'm not saying that. Quran, it has rules. You have to understand the meaning. You have to understand the tafsir. Asbab al-tanzil. When you come to that point with the shaykh, with the shiyukh, then you get to the point to understand the Quran as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking to your heart directly. And to conclude, Brother Saleh, am I okay with the time?
No. So you're fine. Go ahead. You're fine. Go ahead.
So basically, I like every time when we have a lecture like this, or anybody, you know, give a lecture, action items. And the action item means to translate. The theory would be nothing like the ilm, like Iblis, he knows the most, but in the practical side, he did nothing. So basically, I want to remember and I remind everyone that the whole world is too small. The whole world today is showing us that Corona or COVID-19 showed there is no difference between white and black. There's no difference between rich and poor. There is everybody in the same boat today. Everybody is afraid in the same way. And that's what we learn in Islam. لا فرق بين عربي وعجمي ولا أسود ولا أحد على إلا بالتقوى, right? So this is the meaning of like the faith will stay, but what's happening in the world will change. Finally, the meaning of the ayah, واتقوا فتنة لا تصيبن الذين ظلموا منكم خاصة. سبحان الله, when something happen, it hit in front of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Like a place where we inshallah replace what we missed until Allah give us the fajr and go back to our masajids and pray together. And and I think the most important thing mentioned that to start a project that we all contributed. I think maybe this is the all of us work today by assuming we have to save our and to make our center very powerful by all of us working to provide what other people throughout وتعالى through the responsibility of saving our center that we all of us have to have مسابقة competition among all of us. And I hope, you know, I know there is one one-way communication in the questions. I think that will be one of the most important project that we all carry the responsibility together to make our masjid function in the same way, even if not better. This is what's coming to my mind when you ask me to speak, Shaykh. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save you all. And when I say just stay healthy, be safe, and inshallah, whatever happening today will become history tomorrow, and inshallah, we'll go through it stronger with more iman, inshallah. Jazakumullahu khairan wa barakallahu fikum.
Thank you very much. Thank you for this uplifting message. As you all know, we're 5 days away from Ramadan, and obviously, this is an anxious and sad situation at the same time. And so, those action points are exactly what's needed right now, you know, to raise our spirits and motivate us to take advantage of this blessed month, regardless of the situation. So if anyone has any questions, you could go ahead and raise your hand.
Hamd is here, I think he is, by default.
I want to give the brother Jazakallah kulli khair. May Allah reward you, inshallah. And inshallah, I need the brothers and sisters to have a chance, inshallah, to ask their questions, inshallah.
I have a question. If I may go first. What's your plan for a tarawih at home? Your personal plan as a family?
One more time.
Did you hear me?
Cut off.
Sorry, I said, what's your family's plan for tarawih at home?
Different. First of all, we have a small plan. Inshallah, Osama and Anas both with us, alhamdulillah. So Osama will lead the prayer for tarawih every day. And I some scholars working today that, you know, to allow to pray over the social media, over there is fatwa being developed. I've been a meeting today for the whole day with the Mass National. So if the fatwa took place by Tuesday, then the Imam will be Sheikh Hamdi, for example, and we can follow the prayer. But my personal plan, so inshallah, every single day we'll make it as we're going to have tarawih, inshallah, every single day. We're going to have for the family Quran, basically. What is the all inshallah recite from the same start in Sunnah, and hopefully as a family read the 8 pages will count as a khitmat al-bayt inshallah. That's one thing. And the second thing, what we would love to do as a family, to find other families need help, and if we can do something for them in order to, you know, not because we want to help, because we are looking for some reward inshallah to do this. This is basically in general. Fasting will be the same. Hopefully we'll invite one family. I'm not asking you to invite anybody, but like, you know, the iftar with them, just to keep the social life going on, inshallah, during the month of Ramadan. And attend the lectures, definitely, with the shuyukh. Inshallah. This is in general. After this, my wife, may Allah be pleased with her, she had a plan for the kids to watch something they love to watch. For example, they watch Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. In Ramadan, we'll have this episode continue with the Sahaba. So they will understand the 10 promised al-Jannah, for example, in their own way and present it in the end of this episode. To us, inshallah.
Barakallahu feek. Barakallahu feek. Anyone else have a question?
Assalamu alaikum, Dr. Ahmad.
Barakallah.
محمد نجار.
الفاتحة. بارك الله فيك.
والله الله يسلمك يا رب. جزاك الله كل خير. I would like to maybe give some advice to our youth. I know since they born until now, I think they live in very good life.
Yes.
In America. And until the corona, and now after the corona, I believe they are still living in very, very good life and with a lot of na'am. الله عز وجل. And they still, they have electricity, they have their TV, they have their bed, they have their food, they have a lot of ni'ams. But we still, we notice that they are like, some of them, they feel like, oh my gosh, I'm bored, I don't feel well, we need to go out. What is your advice to our youth? I mean, what can, if you can say a few words to them, please.
Allah khair, and I think this is yani a very, very sensitive topic. I think for the youth, and the youth, I don't know what you mean by youth, you know, like, okay, you're included, I'm included, right?
Yes.
For the youth, basically, number one, at home right now, they should share the responsibility by understanding the life is not for them only. Their life, the purpose of life, that to contribute to the community at large. Their life is to check in the people they need their help. So basically, I hope that the youth will be, number one, connected to the Quran and understand why the companions are so unique and the Prophet ﷺ, how he educated them. So basically, I'm not asking them to be living that age, which is really amazing, but I'm asking them to understand how to worry about the whole community. That's number one. Number two, this world is not by the manpower, like we used to think of United States are the strongest or whatever. So they have to understand, the youth, you know, to share their responsibility with others by understand how to read about, you know, the current situation, understand the society we live in. How can we change the neighbors? How can we change, for example, in our major? How to be ahead of everyone by understanding, for example, our majors and become very, very successful. But definitely connect, make them believe that, you know, together we can make big difference. Make the image of Islam and Muslims through them better. I think that's very, very helpful. But knowledge is important, and respect and love to their families is really important. And at the same time, to build the right network where together they can work. And I seen, like, you know, Umar Sulaiman, may Allah be pleased with him, when he speaks to the youth, you will find out, you know, there's messages after messages that through your iman, through your connection with the Quran, you will become a leader. So want them to get to that level. I am not young, and my dad knows on me. I am the one who want to take the responsibility in the leadership in the driver's seat. This is one of the quick messages, and I think, you know, give them freedom, understand them, open the channel of communication, don't make them stay away from you, and go to their level. Don't bring them to your level. Very important in the house. And we lie, and I learn, you know, after the quadruplets, then I have the twins. In the twins, I learn a lot. I make them take the, you know, the lead in discussion. I don't take the lead at all. So I just go with them, and we arrive to a conclusion. I think that's what they have to do. Allahu a'lam.
Dr. Ahmed, do you want to take the question that's in the chat box? It's in Arabic, so my I might screw this up.
You have to get it.
So I think ما هي خطأ المسجد بما بعد مرور هذا
ما هي خطأ المسجد لما بعد مرور هذه الأزمة وإعادة فتح المسجد. أنا أعتقد هذا السؤال للشيخ جودة أو للإخوة في الإدارة يعني.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to say.
Very hard, you know, to open the doors when the time allows. I'm sure. The masjid, and I'm sure, يعني, and I can read, I'm reading Jawad's mind. The masjid is today is eager to go back and serve the community in the best way possible. The masjid is open for all the new ideas after Corona, inshallah. So this for the idara, but this is new comments. يعني.
What was the question? Can you translate the question, please?
Oh, the question, what is the plan of the masjid to do after this Corona, COVID-19? What the plan for the masjid, you know, what do they want to do?
Any other questions? Okay, Sheikh Hamdi, did you have any announcements?
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. جزاكم الله كل خير.
بارك الله فيك.
وتقبل الله تبارك وتعالى منا ومنكم. May Allah accept from all. الحمد لله to have together to remind each other, to listen to each other, to participate in this meeting. Wallahi, for sure, our iman increased Alhamdulillah, by seeing, listening to each other, understanding some points we do not understand it before. So inshallah, may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala help all of us inshallah. About the fatwa, they are still working. When the people, even yesterday, brother Dr. Khalid Bahijri, he talked to me during the lecture yesterday, and he texted me that it is permissible to pray Taraweeh behind the Imam in the Masjid and we are at home. I said till now, because do you know, now is not the time for individual fatwa. No one individual can give fatwa and it is, it will be valid. No, we need majma' fiqhi, we need majama' fiqhiya, we need group of scholars to give this fatwa, to sponsor this fatwa. I did not read it yet, what Dr. Ahmad mentioned, but I know that many people, we were talking with Dr. Muzammil and with many shiukh, but there is no final fatwa yet about to pray Taraweeh or Isha behind the Imam or Jum'ah behind the Imam online. So till now, inshallah, till now, if anything in you, for sure, we'll inform you about it. Till now, inshallah, our plan, as we mentioned before, inshallah, our plan in Ramadan, inshallah, if the situation is still and no clear fatwa came out, inshallah, so inshallah we'll continue to listen to the juz of the Quran from Sheikh Uthman and Sheikh Muhammad al-Katib at 9 o'clock, have juz, and between these two halves, inshallah we'll have short talk by one of the guest speakers. Then you can pray Taraweeh at home, short Taraweeh, not necessarily long. So pray Isha and the Taraweeh, and the Taraweeh can be just 8 short surah from juz. After listening one juz, alhamdulillah, and I mentioned also, when you listen to the Quran, this one juz, have wudu, face the qibla, open the Quran, be ready, it's part of ibadah also, inshallah. And the program after Fajr will be. So if any strong fatwa came out to do that, inshallah, we hope that the group, the scholars, they will do their best, inshallah, to come out with, most correct one, inshallah, to help all of us to enjoy Ramadan. But anyway, also, if not happen, enjoy your Salat Qiyam at home also. You can enjoy Salat Al-Qiyam at home. We have to know that also our Salat Qiyam at home, that's good also. Let us fill our houses this year, inshallah, with this ibadah also. Wallahi, that's not our choice. That's from Allah. So inshallah, we can also fill our houses with يعني ذكر with صلاه with استغفار with دعاء with ان شاء الله باذن الله, which is good also, new practice. As anyway, the scholar, they said, what happened this waba, what happened now, international waba everywhere in the world, that's happened in the history, in the host, strong one, not ta'un, that even the waba happened 4 times, even 2 before Islam and the 2 after Islam. The map of the world, it changed after that. All the map of the world is changing after that. Maybe the oppressors, they go extremely in the wrong way. So maybe Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will correct this upside down position to correct it in the right way, inshallah. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala give us all the benefits from this calamity and help all of us, inshallah, to use it wisely, to practice wisely in this difficulty. And may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala make it short and return all back, inshallah, to better life. And I like the point mentioned by Dr. Marwa Azab. She said, the people now, they said, we want to go back to our normal life. No, inshallah, the life before is not the best. Inshallah, we hope, inshallah, we'll be better than before after that. Inshallah, we hope to be better than what we used to do before, inshallah. After that, will be inshallah better in iman, better in practice, better in akhlaq, better in preparing for death, better in all ways, inshallah. And even we learned WebEx and Zoom and mishaarif. Alhamdulillah, we learned something. I don't know how to learn it before, but now inshallah we are working in this difficult ways, inshallah. Jazakum Allah kulli khair, taqabbalallah minna wa minkum. And inshallah, as usual, tomorrow inshallah we have also night talk at 8:45, and also inshallah biiznillah morning 5:45 as usual. That's halaqat al-Quran 5:45 to read one juz inshallah biiznillah. Jazakum Allah khair, taqabbal Allah minna wa minkum wa ghafara Allah lana.
I have a question for you, Sheikh Hamdi. have a question
for Ahmad Farasht. Allah yakramak.
Jazakallah khair.
Sheikh Ahmad, I have a question for Sheikh Hamdi.
طب يلا.
Is there any any lectures during Ramadan?
إيه تاني؟
Are there going to be any lectures?
Yes, every day, inshallah, at Asr time, tafsir. At 5 o'clock, tafsir every day, inshallah.
Jazakallah khair.
And also short talk after Fajr every day, inshallah.
Jazakallah khair.
الحمد لله. لا سلامتك.
الله يبارك فيك. تسلم.
شكرا. الله يبارك فيك. ربنا يحفظكم جميعا ان شاء الله. ان شاء الله والاند باي دعاء فروم براذر احمد عزام اذان باي محمد زهدي ان شاء الله.
السلام
عليكم. عند اذان بعد صالح ان شاء الله يو كان كوردينيت ذات دعاء باي دكتور احمد عند اذان
باي محمد. دعاء باي شيخ؟ لا معك انا حابس دعاءك.
لا معلش معلش احنا بنغير اللي بيدعو كل يوم عشان ناخذ ذا بيست ان شاء الله.
لا اليوم خلي عليك. تفضل يا شيخ.
يلا دكتور احمد يور اب. تفضل.
ذا هوست تولد يو. الحمد لله.
Can anyone hear? No sound?
يبدو الصوت راح يا اخ احمد.
Is there sound?
صوت انقطع مش عارف ليه يا اخ احمد. هل سمعني يا اخ احمد؟ هل سمعني يا اخ؟ Can you hear me صالح؟
Yes, I can hear you.
وظنت هي أحمد.
Okay, Sheikh Hamdi, Dr. Ahmed, are you back? Okay, Sheikh Hamdi, go ahead and take over. Can you do the dua, please?
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. اللهم اغفر ذنوبنا واستر عيوبنا وتولى أمرنا ولا تخيب بفضلك رجاءنا. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية والمعافاة الدائمة في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. اللهم استر عوراتنا وآمن روعاتنا واحفظنا وأهلينا والمسلمين والمسلمات من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعن أيماننا وعن شمائلنا ومن فوقنا، ونعوذ بعظمتك أن نغتال من تحتنا. اللهم ارحمنا فإنك بنا راحم، ولا تعذبنا فأنت علينا قادر، والطف بنا يا مولانا فيما جرت به المقادير. اللهم بلغنا رمضان وارزقنا صيامه وقيامه إيمانا واحتسابا يا رب العالمين. اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا واجعلنا في الدنيا متحابين وفي الآخرة على سر متقابلين. اللهم انزع الغل والحقد والحسد من صدور المؤمنين، واجعلنا لك ذكارين لك شكارين، عليك متوكلين إليك منيبين، لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ولآبائنا وأمهاتنا ولإخواننا وأخواتنا ولأزواجنا وأولادنا وبناتنا ولأهلينا ولأقاربنا ولمن له حق علينا ولمن علمنا ولمن أوصانا بالدعاء. اللهم أحسن ختامنا ويسر حسابنا ويمن كتابنا وبيض يوم القيامة وجوهنا واجعلنا يوم القيامة من الآمنين. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من البرص والجنون والجذام، ونعوذ بك من سيء الأسقام. اللهم ارفع البلاء والوباء عنا وعن جميع خلقك يا رب العالمين. ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا، ولا تؤاخذنا بسوء فعالنا ولا بما فعل السفهاء منا، ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا. أصلحنا، حبب الأزواج إلى زوجاتهم والزوجات إلى أزواجهن. اللهم اهد أولادنا وأولاد المسلمين وبناتنا وبنات المسلمين، واجعلنا جميعا من أهل القرآن القارئين للقرآن العاملين بالقرآن المستمتعين بتلاوة القرآن. اللهم متعنا يا رب، متعنا في الدنيا بكلامك ومتعنا بالنظر إلى وجهك يوم القيامة يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك رحمة من عندك تغننا بها عن رحمة من سواك، نسألك العافية في الدين والدنيا والآخرة، وصل اللهم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. آمين إن شاء الله.
جزاك الله خيرا. أنا يمكن
قطع عندي. من عندك يا أخ أحمد؟
نعم نعم، معذرة والله.
نعم،
الحق على صالح، صالح فولت.
الله يكرمك يا سيدي. طيب نسمع الأذان إن شاء الله.
Before I invite Sheikh Uthman to for the Adhan, I just want to let you all know we're working on a survey. We're going to ask you how we can improve these WebEx meetings, what we're doing right, what we could be doing better. So be on the lookout for that within the next few days. Inshallah. Sheikh Uthman?
I think Sheikh Uthman is not here.
Okay, who's going to do it?
See, Muhammad Zuhdi, inshallah. Muhammad Zuhdi?
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I don't see Sheikh Osman here tonight. So inshallah Muhammad Zuhdi can raise Adhan inshallah.
Inshallah, barakallah. Allahu Akbar, Allah Akbar. الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله